Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you a new Python library called PandasAI. PandasAI works together with Pandas to make it more interactive. With PandasAI you can ask questions about your data frame and it will provide the answers. To give you a better idea, I will show you an example. So without further ado, let us dive in. Here in my Jupyter notebook, I will start off by creating a sample dataset. Let us imagine this. You have a dataset containing a list of countries and their respective GDP and happiness index. Before demonstrating PandasAI, let us use only Pandas to analyze the data. Based on this data, suppose you want to find the top 5 happiest countries. One way to achieve this is to apply n largest on the happiness index and extract the country column. When I execute this cell, we will see that the happiest countries are Canada, Australia, the UK, Germany, and the US. If you want to add the GDPs of the two unhappiest countries, you can use n smallest and then add the GDPs as I did here. Once I run this cell, I will get my answer. Next, let us create a histogram showing the GDP for each country. The additional requirement is that the chart should use different colors for each country. To do this, I have imported matplotlib and seaborn. After that, I will create a color palette with different colors for each unique country. Having set that up, I can now use the built-in plotting capabilities from Pandas to generate the chart. For better clarity, I will also assign a title and X and Y labels. The final chart will look like this. So far, so good. Now I'm going to guide you through the same example, but this time we will use PandasAI. So let's create the same data frame we had earlier. Before diving into PandasAI, you will need to install it. Just run pip install PandasAI in your command prompt or terminal and you're all set. Once that is done, you can import PandasAI from the PandasAI package and I will also import the large language model OpenAI from PandasAI. To use OpenAI, you will need an API key. To get one, head over to the OpenAI website, log into your account and click on Personal in the upper right corner. Navigate to View API Keys and click on Create New Secret Key. Optionally, you can also give it a name. And now you've got your API key. With that in place, I will initialize the PandasAI object. We can use this object to tackle our questions once more. Simply use the run method, followed by the data frame and your prompt. When you execute it, you will get the response. As you can see, we have the same countries as before, so it's definitely working. Next, let us add the GDPs of the two unhappiest countries. Just like before, I will use the run method with my data frame and prompt. When I execute the cell, we will get back the answer. Lastly, let us see if we can use PandasAI to plot the histogram. Running the cell might take a moment, but once done, we will have our simple histogram with each country in a different color. So, as you can see, you can ask your question directly about your data frame without writing any code yourself. I think we will see more of such tools in the future. But for now, I would rather write my own Pandas code, because it lets me know how the data is processed. That said, for validating results or just playing around with the data, I think it's an interesting tool. But keep in mind that this library is pretty new, with the first release just 2 weeks ago. There might be still bugs and new features could be added in the future. Now let us also address the elephant in the room. Is it safe to use? And what about privacy and security? For that, let us look at the official GitHub repo. As explained there, the data is randomized and only the head of the data frame will be analyzed through the API. If you only want to share your column names and not the head, you can set enforce privacy to true. Additionally, remember that using the OpenAI API key isn't free. It is relatively affordable, but it's good to be aware. You can find more information about pricing on the OpenAI website. So what do you think about PandasAI? Will you give it a try? Let me know in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.